Good Kids by Benjamin Nugent, narrated by Charlie Thurston. 1994. Chapter 1. We're not going to get thrown in a van. The dads were a man and a woman. They were my father, Linus, and Khadijah's mother, Nancy. Khadijah called them the dads because, in her family, Nancy played the traditional paternal role. She spent more time at work than Khadijah's father. She made more money. She was harder to talk to. She was a dad. And my father was a dad. To explain why we needed a name for the pair of them, I'll start with the Friday that Khadijah and I, with our respective dads, ran into each other at Gaia Foods. The Day of the Dads. It was early March, Language Day at Wattsberry Regional. As sophomores active in language clubs, I, Russian, Khadijah, French, we both manned tables selling borscht and mousse outside the cafeteria after school. We never spoke during Language Day, although our tables stood 5 feet apart. All I knew about Khadijah was that she was third-tier popular. All academics, no sports, no theater, no newspaper. An organized girl who recorded homework assignments in apple-green pen in high-quality notebooks, and that her deceptively black-sounding name, pronounced Khadijah, was a product of Nancy's Sufi years. My father picked me up after we collapsed the tables at 5, and we stopped at Gaia on the way home for dinner essentials, wine, and ice cream. After Nancy picked up Khadijah, they stopped at Gaia too. While I was trying to show my father how smart I was by making an argument about how many pears he should buy versus how many grapes for a fruit salad, I saw Nancy and Khadijah hovering by bananas. An astute observer probably would have seen there was something weird between Nancy and my father right away. But I was only 15. I was stupid when it came to interpreting the behavior of the dads. It's strange. When you're trying to impress a person, you can't see that person well. And Khadijah and I, we longed to impress the dads. I noticed nothing unusual in the dads' body language or in their faces. My father reached out and laid his hand on the pears peeking from Nancy's wicker basket, looked her in the eye, and said, "They're fresh today." The gesture did not strike me as remarkable. I found it mysterious, but my father was a sophisticated person. Everything he did was mysterious. "Sometimes," he hastened to explain, looking at Khadijah and me stroking his beard, "the fruit at Gaia is slightly rotten. That's the dark side of organic. Everything isn't spritzed with poisons to make it look neat." I was, myself, as odious as aging fruit. My parents were hippies. They had not spritzed me with poisons to make me look neat. My blonde, shoulder-length hair was triangular, because while I knew there was a hair product called conditioner, I didn't know that conditioner was what people use to make their hair lie down. I hadn't acquired the habit of shaving my ghost mustache or wiping the fingerprints off the lenses of my glasses. I wanted to be like my father, who taught political science, who knew how to talk about capitalism in a way that people either agreed heartily with him or looked personally affronted and concerned for their safety. I wanted his air of rebellion and authority, his shaggy dark hair and revolutionary beard. But I didn't know how to turn myself into him. I was wearing one of his blousy, long-sleeved shirts from the early 70s that I'd discovered in our attic, green with wooden buttons, and the consequence was that I smelled as if I were kept in an attic. Khadijah, by contrast, had the grooming and bearing of a girl with a hands-on mother. She stood straight and still. The burgundy scrunchie that held her brown ponytail matched the trim of her Esprit socks. But for all the inorganic, detail-oriented parenting lavished on her, she was almost as awkward as I was, no sure of how to start a conversation. When the dads asked for some time to chat by themselves...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.